Praise the Lord. My name is Witness Ken Paul Obieke, the President of Heaven's Mandate, the End Time Army. Today, I am starting a series on the topic, the gospel versus empty gossip. The gospel versus empty gossip. I want you to quickly look into the Word of God, take your Bible, so that you'll be sure of what you are hearing, to be saved from the confusion, from strange wind of doctrines and all manner of things that are going on today all over the places. The book of Galatians chapter number 1, I start reading from verse 6. And it says, I marvel that ye are soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel. I marvel. Paul was shocked when he saw a war that was being waged against the gospel of Jesus Christ by the Pharisees, the Sadducees, and most regrettably today, this same war is going on. People who are redeemed by the grace of God, but instead prefer to stay and die under the law and under works, which cannot save anybody. And the other set of people who are out to abuse the grace that Jesus Christ purchased with so much a great price. These two sects of people are completely in error and are bringing confusion that will not allow many people to make heaven. Now, Paul looked at these people. The Bible made us understand that we are saved by grace through faith. But Paul looked at these people and saw that they preferred to remain under the bondage of law. Law failed. That was why grace came. And grace came with the understanding that no human being can be able to do what? To stand right before God. And that's what makes Christianity not just a religion. That is what makes Christianity different from every other religion. Grace came. By the way, what is grace? Grace is an unmerited favor. Salvation is a gift from God. Now, if salvation is a gift from God, that means, according to the scripture, we are not saved by works, we are not saved by any law, we are saved by grace. We are saved by grace through faith. Now, as believers, what does this mean for us? What this means is that our total dependence is meant to be on what Jesus Christ has done. And that was why Jesus Christ said, it is finished. What does that mean? Nothing is meant to be added. Nothing is meant to be extracted from what Jesus Christ has done. Anyone that does that has fallen out of grace into damnation. I said something about these two sects. The other ones are abusing the grace. They prefer the gift to the giver. They love the gift more than the giver. And so they abuse the gift. And then the other set of people are there, what is their own? Looking for laws and works that will put them in another bondage. Don't brush your teeth. Don't smile. Don't rub powder. Don't do this. Don't do that. Undermining the truth that works and laws cannot save anybody. Now look at the other category. Abuse, complete abuse of grace. And that is why, what are we producing today? We are producing Christianese. People that have nothing to do with Christ. All these sects of people are all under abuse and are heading to hellfire. Now look at the next verse of the Bible. It says, which is not another. But there be some that trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. I'm reading verse 7. It says, which is not another. But there be some that trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. The perversion of the gospel of Jesus Christ is what is going on everywhere. Like I try to say, those who claim grace are doing what? Swimming in disgrace. Because they see grace as a license for nonsense. They see grace as opportunity to continue in sin. Whereas the other set of people undermine grace and are doing what? Making jest of themselves. Look at these days what is happening. What you hear these days everywhere today is people dying and going to heaven and going to hell to come back with fear of hell. As if you can use the fear of hell to bring somebody to heaven. The only thing that can bring anybody to heaven is grace. Praise the Lord. This is oil for the wise virgins. Here you see Prepare for Rapture, a book you must read if you want to make rapture. In this one that is titled Stop Just Going to Church, you will see that Christianity is different from going to church. Churchianity is not Christianity. I want you to read this book. It is going to help you a lot. Here we have 99% of ministers and churches on the way to hellfire. This is mind-blowing. It's a book you must read. We have Behold, I Come Quickly. How many people are ready? How many people are preparing under the urgency of heaven? This book will help you a lot. This one is called The Battle of Sexual Immorality. Sexual immorality has destroyed the society and is holding the church captive, whether you understand it or not. This book will help you, no matter who you are, to be saved. This one is titled The Padlock of Your Wedlock. It's for the single and the married. Marriages are becoming gates to hell instead of gates to heaven. This book will help you whether you are married or single. And so you see all manner of nonsense gospel, nonsense revelations going up and down. This one say women should cut their hair. This one say women should not be talking anymore. This one say this one should do this, this one should do that. As if salvation is dependent on what we do. Let me tell you something and make it very clear to you. Salvation is about what Jesus Christ has done and not what any man is doing. That is salvation. Now, the Bible makes us understand that if the grace of God is no more where you are standing, you cannot stand right with God. I want to read some scriptures and I paint a very clear picture that will enable you to escape from this confusion that is everywhere. Now, I want you to look at this scripture, look it very well, and see what the Lord is trying to bring unto us here. He says in the next verse, in verse eight, look at it very well. He said, but though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. If any other person, be that person an angel, brings to you any other gospel that contradicts the grace of God, let that person be accursed. But what are we seeing today? Accursed so-called revelations, accursed preachings, accursed Christians. And that is why you look at some of the people who say they are Christians. There's nothing to show that Christ died for them. All the reproaches that grace is meant to disgrace have their houses in their lives. There is a one minister these days that is preaching in abroad. His topic is only grace. And what is that man preaching? Disgrace. Because his own understanding of grace is that grace is a license for nonsense. His own preaching of grace is meant to make people to add iniquity to iniquity as people who Jesus Christ has died for, have saved, and who have nothing else to add to what Jesus Christ has done. Yes, we do not have anything to add to what Jesus Christ has done, but a tree must bear fruit according to its type. When Christ has saved us, Christ saved us out of sin, and we are meant through that grace to live outside sin. Now, I want to show you something again, and this is very important. It said in verse 9, as we said before, so I say I now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that ye have received, let him be accursed. Now, Paul made this clear in two verses. If any man bring any other gospel to contradict what is the true gospel. What is the true gospel? The true gospel is what is called good news. And what is the good news? The good news is that you and I, that we are not qualified, have been qualified by Christ, by what Jesus did. And that's why the scripture says, no other foundation shall any man lay, except that which is already laid, which is Christ Jesus. Now, the foundation has been laid, and the word of God went on and said, if any man build on this foundation, let it be according to the order of Christ. Now, what is he saying? If Christ saved you from sin, are you supposed to return and remain in sin? Or now add sin to your sin? No is the answer. Now, the other way around, those people that are bringing works, these days is as if the gospel of Jesus Christ has been turned to the gospel of earring. A lady was telling me something yesterday, that at a point in time, any woman that wears earring, she was not talking to. I said, you are already in bondage of hellfire. Because Jesus Christ did not bring us under law of anything, in as much as we discourage people from wearing it. Nobody that tells you that not wearing a ring will take you to heaven is of God. And any revelation that comes and makes not wearing a ring or looking like one wet rat or looking like vulture is what will take you to heaven is bringing you under the curse of law. It is not true. We discourage people from these things, but nobody is under law or under works anymore in Christ Jesus. All these stupid CDs, all these lies everywhere are from where? The pit of hellfire. It has nothing to do with grace. The gospel of Jesus Christ is a gospel of grace. But that grace is not grace that is meant to be abused. Now, look at the next verse of the Bible. It says, verse 10, for do I now persuade men or God, or do I seek to please men? For if I yet pleased men, I should not be the servant of Christ. Verse 11. But I certify you, brethren, that the gospel which was preached of me is not after man. Verse 12, finally. For I neither received it of man, neither was I taught it, but by the revelation of Jesus Christ. Brethren, let me say this and say it very clearly. Any gospel that brings you under works and under laws is an accursed gospel. It's a gospel that is an empty gossip. It's a gospel that have cancelled the finished work of Jesus Christ. So it's an accursed gospel. And this is not to say that you are not supposed to have good works. That you are not saved by works does not mean you won't have good works. The Bible says that we are to do what? To die unto Christ, for Christ to live in us. Now, when Christ is living in you, there will be the reflection of the righteousness of Jesus Christ. You cannot say you are born again and be a sinner or living in sin. The This one is titled Satanic Churches. Most of the churches you see everywhere today are satanic because they are no more preparing people for heaven. And moreover, Satan has transformed himself into angel of light and is deceiving a lot of people through the church. Now, this one is titled Time is Finished. When you finish reading this, you get born again, again and again. There's no more time. The angels that are going to blow the trumpet of rapture were shown to me, showing that there's no more time, and many are not yet ready. This one is the judgment day. How will you stand on that day? Here you will see revelation of how the great, the mighty, the low, we are judged. This book will help you to be able to stand well that day and be able to escape the wrath of God. This one is tied to you and your pastor, Mosiadis. If you have not read this, you have not read anything. There are things in this book that will open your eyes and make you wiser than the serpent. Now, this one is called Tears in Heaven. The book of life was revealed to be empty, and Jesus Christ was shedding tears. I want to ask you, is your name in this book of life? When you read this book, you will know what I'm talking about. This one is called Pure Prosperity. Some wonder whether children of God are meant to prosper. Prosperity is part of our salvation. Salvation is total package. When you read this book, you will know the difference between the mundane prosperity and the totality of the prosperity that every true child of God is supposed to have. The other way around, you cannot say that you have been saved by grace and then you are depending on works. This is why today, what happened? You see many people live in fear of hellfire. And those people who think that they can use the fear of hellfire to bring people to heaven are what? Accursed preachers. It is, doesn't work like that. We preach about hell, we preach about heaven to show you the what? The two ends of eternity. And then reveal to you the love of God, which is the only thing that saves. It is the love of God, not the fear of hell. Whatever you are doing, when you relinquish your sin because of fear of hell, that is not what is going to make you not to go to hell. It will send you to hellfire. Because that is not obedience to God. That is not what the scripture says. That is not how it's supposed to be. And that is what we are seeing everywhere now. And that is why all these CDs you see today, what do they do mostly? They put you under the bondage of fear of hell. And then these people hold you as their mugu. You continue to buy CDs that are doing what? Generating fears in you. And the Bible tells us in the book of Revelation that the first people to enter hell are the fearful. There is nothing. There is nothing the devil is not using now to make sure that the entire harvest goes for him and not for God or for Jesus Christ. There's no kind of people the devil is not raising at this time to make sure that the gospel of Jesus Christ is not perverted. All this outward look appearance. Thank God that Kumuyi has come out and denounced these people and banned his people, the Deeper Life Christian members, not to watch these CDs anymore. Not to mind them, that they are complete deceivers. And I add voice to that to say, these are complete deceivers. Nobody dies and goes to heaven and goes to hell and come back. Last week I was talking to you and I called it what? Obanje Gospel. This is Abiku Gospel. The Bible says it's appointed for man once to die after that judgment. Dying and going to heaven and going to hell and coming back to infuse fear in people cannot save anybody. Even when you think people are answering altar call and they are crying, you think they're saved? They are not saved anything. What saves is not the fear of hell. What saves is the love of God. Even when they have come like that, they must need to be made to understand something very important. What brings the new repentance? It is godly sorrow, not fear of hell. Godly sorrow. When you have come to realize that you have wronged God, and you look at what Jesus Christ did for you to reconcile you, you have godly sorrow, not fear of hell. The fear of hell is not the beginning of wisdom. The fear of hell shows you will go to hellfire. Look at the women today. Some of them are smelling. Don't use powder. Don't use perfume. Don't do this. Don't do that. Is that still the message of grace? Gospel is message of grace. Inasmuch as we preach against abuse, there's nothing wrong with use. Now, I want to round up by showing you this in this scripture. In Galatians chapter 3, Paul was mad at this religious bondage people. He said in verse 1, "You foolish Galatians, who had bewitched you that ye should not obey the truth, before whose eyes Jesus Christ had been evidently set forth, crucified among you. This only would I learn of you, receive ye the Spirit by the works of the law, or by the hearing of faith? Are ye so foolish, having begun in the Spirit, are ye now made perfect by the flesh? Have ye suffered so many things in vain? If it be yet in vain." Look at that. Paul called them foolish people because they have been diverted into another gospel and they did not know. Brethren, this is end time warning. This is to open your eyes. This is for those of you who don't want to run their Christian faith in vain, to take precaution. This message is coming in series. And I want you to understand it very well. The gospel versus empty gossips. What we have everywhere now are empty gossips. And you better return back to your Bible and locate what the gospel of Jesus Christ is about. What is the meaning of good news? Good news is the gospel because it's the gospel of grace. But that grace is not meant to be abused. That grace is meant to be used. If you are not graced, you will be disgraced. See you next week. Remember to pick these books because they are the oil for what? The wise virgins at this hour that the trumpet is about to sound. My name is Witness Ken Paul Obiakye. I'm going to be in Benin. I will be in Abuja, Port Harcourt. I will be in America. I will be in Calabar. I will be in Boko. I will be in Cross River State. I want you to take note of this. Call us and get the information and join us. God is doing wonders everywhere I go. Ask all the people that have come to the crusades or the programs everywhere and see what Jesus Christ is doing in this final time of the end time through this very wonderful move that the Lord has brought to save mankind. God bless you. See you next week. This one is titled Strive to Enter. Something that you need to strove to enter heaven, or catwalk even. This book will help you to make heaven. This book is going to teach you a lot of things you do not know. God bless you as you read it. This one is Remember Lost Wife. This is The Woman Never to be Forgotten. And any Christian who doesn't remember lost wife will never make heaven. She only looked back and became a pillar of salt and is in hellfire. What about you? This one is titled Grace to Win the Race. Sometimes some people wonder whether there will be people that will make heaven. There is grace that will make it possible. And you discover it in this book and be able to make it. This one is called The Highest Height of Deceit. What you see everywhere these days is deceit. Preachers that are deceiving people, people that are deceiving themselves. As the devil has transformed himself into angel of light and his ministers into ministers of righteousness, what do you have? A terrible condition in the church. Even people who are claiming divine revelation of heaven and hell, whereas they have nothing to do with God. This book will expose them and naked them for you. This one is the book of all books, Meet Jesus Live. A Christian that has not encountered Christ is a counterfeit Christian. Jesus is a living Savior. You can encounter him now and in eternity. Jesus Christ is meant to be met one-on-one, and he can solve your problem. He can attend to you, even as he did in the Bible days, when you come in contact with this very book. Read them. They are the oil for the wise virgins of this end time.